Welcome to Qigong episode 3. Get ready. Left, right, left, right, left, right. Hands, camera, gang. Gotcha. too easy. That's what this is all about. Practicing the new martial art of Qigong. Now, it's a really exciting martial art, and it will really inspire and develop your understanding of life, nature, the universe, everything. Now, as you walk around the place, just think to yourself, left, right, left, right, left, right, hands, bang! Got you again. You know, it's too easy. You might be able to do this if you really, really practice. Or if you're walking down the street and you run up against someone that's actually doing the same Qigong exercise as you at that exact particular moment, the two of you might just bounce apart. But that is if you don't do this. For example, I might go left, right, hands, camera. And as I went bang, you sort of managed to evade it somehow. But that's what it's all about. Instantaneous reaction. Left hand, right hand, both hands, camera. Now, I'm not actually doing it, but that's what episode 1 and 2 were about. After a while, you know, it takes away the whole sense of it. So you just got to go left, right, camera. Because it's the vibration of the energy of me saying camera distorts the chi field. Now, if we go left, right, camera, bang, strah, and make a bit of a comedy about it. Because as you go bang, you've got to dodge it. But if you can manage to evade it, and you just happen to be walking down the same side of the road as another person practicing Qigong on the earth, which, you know, judging by the rate of people are adopting Qigong into their natural habitat, it might be many a millennia before you actually meet someone else doing the same Qigong exercise as you, going left, right, hands, camera. Now, I'm saying camera, it might be left, right, hands, person. And just as that person walked past and you're doing the same thing, the two of you just bounce apart. Wouldn't that be a wonderful experience? Now, what I want to see happen is I go left, right, camera, you know, and the camera is a pole, and the pole imaginarily, just sort of leans slowly to one side. Wouldn't that be wonderful? You know, it might annoy the council workers, because the council workers will have to come along and fix that goddamn pole, because every time I walk past, they happen to bend it slightly, but that's not my problem, because it might have been someone else doing it. It might have been a car that ran into it yesterday, mate. You know, who knows? But that's the Qigong exercise. Focus left hand to right hand, to left hand to right hand, to hands to camera, you know? Camera. You know, this is getting hard to show you what this experience is all about. But, you know, for instance, there's one person on a comical website called YouTube, and they've got a Taoist, an old Taoist. I'm not sure what country he's from, but he's in Taoism land, obviously, because he's Taoist. Now, he does this magical Qigong, Qigong Taoism, you can name it, Kwai Gong, many terms, but he manages to push a brick over without touching it with Qigong. He also manages to smash a glass without touching it using Qigong. And lastly, he manages to move a pail of water across a table without touching it. Now, this is no word of a lie, because after that he sharpens some knives on his stomach. You know, you've seen all those Taoist monks doing all sorts of gymnastic, acrobatical exercises in your particular country when they come around touring. But, you know, you've got to have some belief that some of the stuff they do is quite unreal. So, what I want to say is, there's this Taoist monk on this website called YouTube. You know, he's amazing. He's been a bit of a inspiration for my life for a number of years, because, you know, it goes to prove there is something out there. You know, it's more than a rare ability. Because for the first time I watched that video, I saw a white spark come, a white flash come out of his hand as he went to move it. Now, some of the books talk about spiraling the chi out of your hand towards the object, but no, it does not work. It does not. Well, it might work if you have thousands of years and practice it for 24 hours a day, but it's more of a bang, bang, exercise, left, right, hands, camera, bang, gotcha, no, you were too quick for me then, you saw what I was doing, I went left, right, hands, camera, bang, and it is possible, because it's more of a flash out of your palm, more of a flash, a thought, without pushing, without trying, without practicing, just effortless thought. And it does work. You know, it's as simple as inspiring the old turtle, giving some energy to walk across on a hot day to get to have a little bit of a drink and a little bit of a feed. You know, it's all about inspiring that general characteristic into life. You know, the nature does have its imprint of the chaos and the fractals and the Mandelbrot. Blah, blah, blah. It does have its very, very simplistic images on a simple leaf to a simple, an island or a planet, you know. Or the universe doesn't make much of a whole lot of a difference. But what we're talking about is Ai Chi Gung. And Ai Chi Gung, perhaps, I'm not saying it is, I'm not saying it isn't, Ai Chi Gu it could be called. Ai Chi Gu is a combination, obviously, of the macro, micro orbits and a grand Nidan circulatory flurry system. It goes into it, but who cares? It's left, right, hands, camera, bang! And that's it. So I hope you've enjoyed my, rather comical exercise. I should go on a little bit more, I suppose, you know. We're looking at the clock here, we're on the 6 minutes, and the last episode actually went for 15 minutes, you know, which is quite a long time in the world of Jigu. Because, you know, the Qigu exercises are quick. You know, there's no mucking about, you know. It comes back to the classical viewpoint of how life was created. You look through things and you see things, you know, 20-20 vision. That came from a classical Qigong exercise. But, you know, you stand 20 metres from a wall, read one paragraph. Practice that for a while. Move 1 metre forward and then try to read that same paragraph and gradually build your sight up. But it's more of that as moving the chi between the wall and yourself, pushing your eyesight, moving your left-right eye circuit, going through the letters, focusing, looking at little different anomalies you see in the line. You can hardly see it at 20 metres, but you look for anomalies. And then slowly you're focusing, slowly you gradually build up your sight. Anything is possible. That's just one simple example of Ai Chi Gung. Ai Chi Gu, Ai Chi Gung, Kwai Gong, whatever you want to call it. It's a basic use of the chi energy, which is in the world at large. Now, I don't want to go on too long. That's not a quick example of many of the fundamental principles of what Qi Gung is based upon. You know, simply enough, you might do a few circuits of Ai Chi Gung, and you pick up a guitar with your eyes closed and you try to play by ear and you accidentally hit the right note first off. Now, you obviously have to have a little bit of practice, a little bit of skill to be able to do that, but you obviously sometimes occasionally hit the right note the first time off. So, left hand, right hand, focus, left hand, hands, camera, Nah, that's a little bit silly. I was getting a bit serious there about the old talk of Ai Chi Gung. You know, you can get serious and you can not be serious, but, you know, we're now up to 8 minutes on the clock, and we, as you know, we could give many, many examples from the old magical Bible, of Ai Chi Gung. But, you know, what else can one say? What else can one say? How could I describe it? You know, I think, they say doing Ai Chi Gung, going yourself, person, and then sort of look vaguely from your left or right. They're using your peripheral vision. And if you got practice that's focusing on that left-right point from your peripheral vision after you originally shared the chi with that person, you would probably see their aura. Now, that depends on, well, what you perceive as being what colour determines what you would perceive that means. Some people, red means fast, go, dangerous, hot. Another person, red means love, life, you know, hope, heart. It goes on. But it's a very theoretical science, I think, anything to do with chakras and clairvoyance and spirituality. Yeah, I can never be able to say that word yet. I always muck it up. Don't worry about that. We're doing our third episode of Ai Chi Gung. Now, Ai Chi Gung comes from the, I think it's the 13th century Qin Shen dynasty of people. And now, a lot of those people had the belief that dying was dying young at 100. Now, dying young at 100, most people don't reach that age nowadays. But these sort of people lived in the forest, and there are talk that the ninjas of the time could jump 10 metres in the air by doing various circuitry systems of chi. Now, a lot of these systems are written about by Mantek Chia. He's one of the great masters of the Tai Chi art amongst the great world at large nowadays. Now, some of these elementary his ways of describing moving chi through your body and harnessing it and focusing it and strengthening parts of your body with it, now they can be added to and extrapolated to quite an extent so you can jump 10 metres in the air. But I think it all comes down to doing a chi gu circuit 1,000 times a day, over and over and over and over and over again. The danger is it goes through your brain. Now, perhaps later I might develop a more specific chi gu circuit that doesn't necessarily go through your brain, so I nowadays do not believe 1,000 times a day through your brain with chi is particularly a good idea, unless you want to be ultra, ultra enlightened and walk around saying, yes, I do, therefore I am. But without that, I don't know, that's ridiculous. You know, you don't want to send chi because you will feel quite enlightened. Now, I think I've probably gone to the 11-minute mark with another one of my little stories. But that's all what it's about, because you go left-hand, right-hand, left-hand, right-hand, camera, bang! And that's the way it works. And obviously, if you say that to yourself and walk around looking at people while you're doing your supermarket shopping, they'll probably contact security on you and you'll have the whole police force surrounding your little shopping trolley and saying, oh, sorry, I was just practicing Qigu. Here's my religious decree for it. Here's my website. Here's what I've been practicing for 10, 15 years. And they'll say, well, you probably shouldn't do that in public or just keep it inside your head because that's about the only sane place that could possibly exist. Now, fuck off. Aichi Gu is probably not a good idea to practice going left, right, bang to people. But I'm just saying there are bad examples, there are good examples, and I don't like focusing on bad examples, because that's what it's all about. Qigong, focusing on the good, the positive, the ultra-high extensions of the human psychic, the ultra-extensions of walking along really fast at night, and trying to self-hypnotize yourself into believing you're taking two steps when you're only taking one. Now, on this self-hypnotism level, that is possible, but on a Qigong level, you can focus the Qi forward. And you might do it 3,000 times, and on one occasion, you accidentally think, yes, I might have achieved that. Now, that's some of the great wondrous ideas. We here at the Church of Qigong actually focus ourselves on you. I'm Church Qigong by Mantek Chia. It's a wonderful, wonderful book. But now I've got a sore neck. I don't really want to lie backwards on two chairs, put end to end, and try to harmonise my back spine. I want it to last a few more years, thank you, Mr. Chia. But anyway, we won't carry on for too long. We're up to the 13.5-minute mark, and as I say, 13 is unlucky, and for some it's lucky. So we'll just keep going. We'll go left, right, left, right. Hands, camera. Left, right, left, right. Hands, camera. Jesus Christ. It's like the Force or something. Have you heard of Star Wars? You know, Star Wars was one of those things invented back in the days of humans. They liked to fantasize about little role-playing games. And they used to carry on, and one day, one of them decided, let's hold a little stick and make it glow. And another bad one said, well, I'll be a bad person, we'll get another stick and make it glow. And then they both fought for ages and ages and ended up killing themselves, and the good guy always wins and end of the story. That's basically Star Wars. But the principle of the thing is, they had some sort of force power, and they could actually move things without touching it. You know, that really makes me think that perhaps the 13th century Qing Cheng dynasty actually came after the Star Wars universe, which was actually not in this universe. So that probably doesn't count. It's got to be in the same universe to count on the time scale you're referring to, doesn't it? I don't know. Anyway, that probably brings us to the conclusion of the episode. We're drawing into the around 15-minute mark before people go to sleep. So we'll send them some Qi and be happy with the world at large. Left, right, left hand, right hand, camera. Left hand, right hand, left hand, right hand. Gotcha. See ya.